And hello, everyone. My name is Peng Sheng Jiao again. And today, in my fellow lecture, I will talk about mechanical nanomaterials that my research group has been working on during the past several years. Okay, and so first, let me again introduce a little bit of myself. And I got my PhD from Michigan State University in the US. And after the postdoc at UPenn, I came to Zhejiang University and have been working as a research professor ever since then. So my research topics mainly focus on advanced materials and structures and their applications in structural health monitoring and energy harvesting in ocean engineering. So today, in my fellow talk, I will cover the following five parts. So first, let's get started from the background and significance. So nowadays, we know that smart cities is a very hot and well-known concept, which covers almost every aspect in our daily lives, right? From transportation, education, to civil infrastructures. And we see that many of them, if not all, are related to structures. Therefore, to fully improve the functionalities of those fields, we have to somehow improve the functionalities of structures, right? Therefore, people have proposed the concept of advanced metastructures. In general, structures in civil and ocean engineering lie in the range from meter scale to nanometer scale, such as the tower, smartphones, human hair, to MEMS, nanotubes, so on and so forth. So there are many human-made artificial structures and materials, right? And so how to improve the functionalities of those human-made structures and materials? There are in general two ways. One is from the material perspective, such as we change the materials from isotropic natural materials to composite, functionally graded, or graphene nanotubes based. And the other approach is from the structural perspective, such as in this study, the researchers have assembled those small units into a large overall structure, such that the geometries of the overall structure don't change, but those small units lead to very extraordinary Young's modulus and density to the structure. And we call this kind of strategy method mechanical nanomaterials. In the past several years, we have developed the mechanical nanomaterials in plate-like configuration, such as these two plates. So we see that they have basket wave and hexagonal patterns. So because they have the thickness at the nanoscale and the length and width are at the millimeter scale, so they have really large aspect ratio. And those ratio, these ratios lead the plates to very interesting mechanical performance. For example, if we consider a piece of paper here and we do this, so when we release, the piece of paper will still be there, but it doesn't perfectly go back to the initial configuration because of those permanent damages, right? On the other hand, there are many materials that can fully recover after large deformation, such as cloth. But those materials typically don't take any load, right? So you see the dilemma is how to develop something that is both stiff and fully recoverable. And here comes our mechanical nanomaterials. In the figure bottom, at the bottom, we see that after large deformation in bending, the strain in the axial that axial direction is about 100%. It can fully recover to the original shape. And more importantly, comparing to the plate, A clear relationship between the objective function and the input variables. And so through some studies, we finally get these expressions. This one is for the effective bending stiffness, and here is the tensile stiffness. And after having these artificial intelligence models, so we validate, we compare the models, the results with a numerical measurement. And we see that the performance is good. So here in this part, we also carry out some sensitivity studies to determine which factor is dominant in the bending and tensile stiffness of the mechanical nanomaterials. And it turns out that thickness is the most important role. This part is the inverse design using the EC model. Okay, so let's get into the very last part of my presentation today, discussion or some applications of mechanical nanomaterials in ocean and civil engineering. So the first application I'd like to talk about is the application in energy harvesting. So let's imagine if we have a plate here and we place the plate between bilateral constraints. And if we apply a cyclic low frequency excitation, let's say axial displacement to the plate, it will buckle, right? And if we keep loading due to the bilateral constraints, the plate will jump into the third buckling mode. And so the, such as in these two figures, here is the side view deformation, and this is the force displacement relationship. And so the advantage of the whole process is it can effectively convert low frequency excitations in the global coordinate into localized high speed vibration. And this vibration can be used to trigger and maximize a piezoelectric such that to generate electrical power. And so to quick summarize the idea of MMPEN, mechanical nanomaterials enhanced piezoelectric nanogenerators, is that we use the post-buckling response to trigger the generator such that it can work under low frequency excitations and is able to convert mechanical energy to electrical energy. And eventually it can be used to generate power, electrical power under, let's say, ocean waves, right? Low frequency ocean waves, and such that it can be used to automatically charge devices in ocean engineering. And the next application for the energy harvester is in structural health monitoring. So let's say if we put the generator together with a wireless sensor and attach them together. Here, attach them together into a bridge, and they can work together to continuously monitor the mechanical response of bridges. Okay, so at the very end, I would like to give another example of the application of mechanical nanomaterials in marine soft robotics. So the idea is we use the combustion of mixed air to power the soft robots to move. And in this design, it is important to make sure that the soft membrane can fully recover after large deformation in expansion, right? So mechanical nanomaterials can be used then to manufacture this soft membrane. Okay, so at the end, let's quick summarize what we were talking about in the presentation. So here, I was talking about artificial materials from the structural perspective, that is mechanical nanomaterials. And we were first talking about the nanofabrication and the testing, and then we did some mechanism analysis using the theoretical, experimental, and numerical approaches. And we also developed an artificial intelligence model using evolutionary computation algorithm. So at the end, we were talking about the two applications of mechanical nanomaterials in ocean engineering. One is for energy harvesting, and the other one is for structural health monitoring. And so at the end, very end, I would like to thank those funding resources for their support and during the past several years of my studies. And also I would like to thank the students in my research group. And that's all for my fellow lecture today. Thank you. Thank you all.